Thank you. Jaya Mudirayat
Nasta Praeshu Vah
Sva Bhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Bhagavati Uttama Sloke
Bhagavati Uttama Sloke
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtiki
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtiki.
We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 5, Text Number
26.
Kala.
Kala.
Vridya
tu
mayayam
mayayam
guna
guna
mayam
mayam
adhoksaja
adhoksaja
purushenatma
purushenatma
bhutena
bhutena
viryam
viryam
adata
adata
viryavan
viryavan.
Kala vritya tu mayayam
Kala vritya tu mayayam
Guna mayam adhoksaja
Guna mayam adhoksaja
Purushen atma bhutena
Purushen atma bhutena
Viryan adata viryavan Vritya tu mayayam
Kala vritya tu mayayam
Guna mayam adhoksaja
Guna mayam adhoksaja
Purushen atma bhutena
Purushen atma
Viryan adata viryavan
Viryan adata viryavan
Kala vritya tu mayayam
Kala vritya tu mayayam
Guna mayam adhoksaja
Guna mayam adhoksaja
Purushenatma bhutena
Purushenatma bhutena
Viryam madata viryavan
Viryam madata viryavan
Kala vritya tu mayayam Guna mayam adhoksaja
Guna mayam adhoksaja
Purushenatma bhutena
Purushenatma bhutena
Viryam adhata viryavam
Viryam adhata viryavam
Guna
kala, the eternal time,
永恒的时间。
Vritya, by the influence of,
在它的影响之下。
Two,
但是。
Mayayam,
Mayayam,
in the external energy.
在外在能量中。
Guna mayam,
Guna mayam,
in the qualitative modes of nature.
在物质自然的属性中。
Adhoksaja, the transcendence.
超然的。
Purushena,
by the Purusha incarnation,
通过 Purusha 的化身。
Atmabhutena, who is the plenary expansion of the Lord?
主的全权扩展。
Viryam,
the seeds of the living entities.
生物体的种子。
Adatta, impregnated.
使之受孕的。
Viryavan,
the
supreme living being.
至尊生物。
Translation.The Supreme Living Being in His feature as a transcendental Purusha incarnation, who is the Lord's plenary expansion, impregnates the material nature of three modes, and thus, by the influence of eternal time, the living entities appear.
译文：至尊生物以他超然的主宰化身的形象。至尊主的完整扩展，是由三种形态构成的物质自然受孕，随后在永恒时间的影响下，生物体出现了。
The offspring of any living being is born after the father impregnates the mother with semen, and the living entity floating in the semen of the father.Takes the shape of the mother's form.
要指生物体繁衍后代时，都是先由父亲将精子注入母亲体内，使其受孕。父亲精液中所携带的物体进入母体后，得到与母亲同样的形体。
Similarly, mother material nature cannot produce any living entity from her material elements.Unless and until she is impregnated with living entities by the Lord Himself.
同样道理，物质自然这位母亲虽有物质原料，但在至尊主本人未将生物注入她体内使她受孕前，她无法繁殖出生物体。
That is the mystery of the generation of the living entities.
这就是生物体繁殖的奥秘之所在。
This impregnating process is performed by the first Purusha incarnation, Karanamavashayi Vishnu.
使物质自然受孕的任务由第一位主宰化身 Karanavasana Vishnu 担任。
Simply by his glance over material nature, the whole matter is accomplished.
他只是用眼睛瞥了一下物质自然，就完成了这项任务。
We should not understand the process of impregnation by the personality of Godhead in terms of our conception of sex.
我们不能以我们所知道的受孕的概念来看人格守神处理这件事的方法。
The omnipotent Lord can impregnate just by his eyes. Therefore, he is called all potent.
全能的至尊主能用眼睛使物质自然受孕，正因为如此，他被称为全能者。
Each and every part of his transcendental body can perform each and every function of the other parts.
他超然躯体的每个部分都可以交替使用。
This is confirmed in the Brahma Samhita, Angani Yasya Shakalendriya Vritimanti.
这在 Brahma Samhita 中得到了描述。
In Bhagavad Gita 14.3, also the same principle is confirmed. Mama yodhiya mahat brahma tasmin garbham dadami aham.
博迦梵歌第十四章的第三节时也证实说，整个物质实体是出生的根源，称为 Brahman, 梵，是我使梵受孕。
When the cosmic manifestation, when the cosmic creation is manifested, the living entities are directly supplied from the Lord. They are never products of material nature.
被创造的物质世界中的生物直接来自至尊主，而绝不是物质自然的产物。
Thus, no scientific advancement of material science can ever produce a living being.
就这一点而言，物质科学家再怎么进步，也造不出活的生物体。
That is the whole mystery of the material nature.
这是物质创造的奥秘之所在。
The living entities are foreign to matter, and thus they cannot be happy unless they are situated in the same spiritual life as the Lord.
生物不属于物质能量的范畴，所以除非与至尊主一样过灵性的生活，否则根本无法快乐。
The mistaken living being, out of forgetfulness of this original condition of life, unnecessarily waste time trying to become happy in the material world.
这些误入歧途的生物遗忘了他们原本所过的灵性生活，一心要在物质世界中寻找快乐，结果白白浪费了宝贵的时间。
The whole Vedic process is to remind one of the essential features of life.
伟达文化的目的就是要告诉人们有关生命的这一基本道理。
The Lord offers the conditioned soulA material body for his so-called enjoyment.
至尊主为了让受制约的灵魂获得所谓的快乐，赐给他一个物质躯体。
But if one does not come to his senses and enter into spiritual consciousness, the Lord again puts him in the unmanifested condition.
但如果他不明白道理，不利用机会复苏灵性意识，至尊主就会让他重新回到创造前不转世的状态。
The Lord is described here as Viryavan, or the greatest potent being, because he impregnates material nature with innumerable living entities.Were conditioned from time immemorial.
这节诗把至尊主称为 Viryavan, 最强有力的至尊生物，是因为他将不计其数的受制约的灵魂都注入了物质自然的体内。这些灵魂自不可追溯的年代起，就一直处在受制约的状态中。
Om Agyana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya.Chaksurun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpa Darubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadarha Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. So we're hearing Maitreya explain to Vidura the process of creation.
现在这个我们在聆听 Vidura 向 Maitreya 解释这个创造的过程。
And in order to explain it, he is telling about how there was some issue. It was between there were other people talking about who was it? Well, Kardama Muni and Devahuti. They were talking in the beginning. They were talking something about creation.
在刚开始的时候，看大妈穆尼和讲述了一些那个关于创造的事情。卡大妈穆尼和德巴呼提之间有一段对话，就是他们在对话中讲述了有关创造的事情。
So he's making the point here that the material creation.Doesn't come about just by chance.
在这个世界当中提到物质创造不是偶然发生的。
But there's people involved.
而是其中有人有生物的介入。
There's a creator behind the creation.
在这个创造背后呢，有一个创造者。
Of course, atheists.They will come up with theories how the world came about.
当然了，那些无神论者呢，会自创出一套创造的方法，创造的来源。
Just like many of you ladies have children.
就比方说，你们很多女士都有孩子。
So in order for you to have a child, there had to be a man involved.
那为了得到一个孩子呢，就必须得有一个男士的介入。
You didn't get a child without contact with a man.
如果你没有和男人的接触的话，你不能够有孩子。
So Srila Prabhupada is applying the same logic to explaining the creation.
所以Srila Prabhupada在这里用到了同样的逻辑来描述物质的创造。
The material nature doesn't produce life.By itself,
物质自然它自己是不会产生生命的。
But there's some intelligent person behind everything.
而是在这一切背后呢，都有一个有智慧的生物。
And that intelligent person, of course, that work is done by Vishnu.
当然了，这个有智慧的生物，那这个工作呢，是由 Vishnu 来完成的。
And these forms are called the Purusha avatars.
而它的这个形象被称为 Purusha avatar, 主宰化身。
There are three Purushas.
有三个主宰化身 Purusha.
Actually, they're all Vishnu.
实际上，他们都属于 Vishnu 范畴。
But they're doing different functions.
但是他们行使不同的功能。
And the first Purusha.Is Mahavishnu.
第一个 Purusha 主宰化身是 Mahavishnu.
Here, Prabhupada uses the name Karanarnavashayi Vishnu.
所以呢，方法在钥匙中描述他的名字为Karanarnavashayi Vishnu.
Karana, because the Lord is residing in the Karana Ocean, the causal ocean.
Karana 是因为这个主为什么躺在这个 Karana 海洋上面，这个海洋是原因之洋。
Just like in Brahma Samhita, we were chanting Brahma Samhita yesterday. We said, Ishvara Parama Krishna Satchit Ananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam. So Karana is the wordThat word is there, Karanarnavashayi Vishnu.
正如我们昨天朗诵的这个 Brahma Samhita, 在 Brahma Samhita 当中有这样的一个诗节，那么其中就有一个词叫做 Karana. Karana 指的就是 Karana Vishnu.
Karana, the cause, the causal ocean. Krishna is the cause of all causes.
Krishna 是所有原因的原因。那 Karana 原因之阳是 所有的是这个主威士罗躺在上面的这个原因之样。
He is the origin of all origins.
他是所有源头的源头。
And he is the cause of all causes.
他是所有原因的原因。
So, the creation comes about just by the glance of Mahavishnu.
所以这个创造之所以发生，是因为主威士努的瞥视。
And Prabhupada said, the process of creation is not like sex in the material world.
所以他法解释到，这个物质自然的创造的过程，并不像普通人的性生活。
Because the Lord has great powers, he has inconceivable powers.
因为主他是全能的，他拥有不可思议的能量。
And we sing about it every day. We sing every day.
我们每天都在唱诵。
We sing about the Lord's powers.
我们每天都能够见证到主的能力。
We just sang it this morning.
我们今天早上刚刚唱诵过。
When we sing Govinda prayers.
我们唱诵这个 Govinda 祷文。
Anganiya shakala. We sing two verses. The first verses we're singing is Venan Kanvan, and then we sing Anganiya shakala. We sing the second verse. Anganiya shakala endriya vritti manti. That the Lord'swith his senses, he can perform the activities of all the other senses.
正如我们每天早上所唱诵的这两段，来自 Brahma Samhita 当中的这两段祷文，我们在第二段祷文当中描述呢，主的所有的感官都有着其他感官的功能，能够交替使用。
He can see with his ears.
他可以用他的耳朵去看。
He can eat with his eyes.
他可以用他的眼睛去吃。
He can smell with his legs.
他可以用他的腿去微笑。
All of the senses are, they can perform the acts of the other senses.
他的每一个感官都能够行使其他感官的功能。
So when he wants to impregnate something,just by his glance, he can do it.
所以他如果想要使某件事物得以受孕的话，他只需要用眼睛瞥视一下就可以做到。
We would have a lot of problems in the material world if men could do that.
如果We
would have a lot of problems.
如果我们在这个物质世界里，如果男人有这种功能的话，那就会产生很多的问题。
Women might find themselves, wow, how did I get this?
那女人就会发现，哦，我怎么会得到这个？
So, only the Lord can do this.
所以只有主才能够做到这一点。
And he impregnates the material nature.
所以他使物质自然得以受孕。
So Prabhupada says, science, the scientists, they're always talking about creating life.
所以他提到说呢，那些科学家总是在想要去创造生命。
And they talk about taking chemicals and producing life.
他们用一些化学原料来制造生命。
And they're trying, of course they do things, now they do things like they have sperm banks, they take the semen from the man and they keep it in the, and they have it in the fridge and the woman wants a child and they will take the semen from the fridge and put it into her.
所以现在呢，那些科学家呢就做这种人工受孕，他们把男人的精子取出来，然后把它冷藏起来，然后如果有女人想受孕的话呢，他们就拿这个男人的精子。
Right, the women, they're so desperate to have a child that even if it's not their husband's semen, they'll take the semen from somebody they don't know, they never heard any, don't know whose it is.
因为有些女人呢，她们实在是太渴望想要孩子了， 所以呢，如果他们没有从丈夫那里得到精子的话呢，他们就从其他的男人那里去得到这个精子，即使是他甚至不认识那个 男人是谁。
But this is their technology.
但这都是那些科学家的一些技术。
But they have to get the semen from a man.
但是他们还是要从男人那里得到精子才行。
They cannot make the semen in the laboratory.
他们是不可能在实验室去得到精子的。
They can analyze the semen, and they can say, well, it's like this, oh, it's blood, it's a transformational blood. But they cannot produce anything which can create a child.
他们自己呢可能会去分析那个精子的成分，然后做一些化学反应什么的，但是呢他们自己是不可能创造出精子来创造一个孩子的。
So Srila Prabhupada said, this is the mystery of the material creation.
所以 Srila Prabhupada 解释说，这是物质创造的奥秘之所在。
So he says, the living entity has to be, he has to understand his spiritual nature.
所以呢，要明白这个生物体它们的灵性本质。
But instead, everyone is trying to make themselves happy in the material world.
但不幸的是，人们都试图在物质自然里寻找快乐。
How will we be happy in the material world?
我们在物质世界里怎么可能会快乐呢？
Oh, we will have a nice house.
我们想要得到一个很漂亮的房子。
We will have a nice husband and children.
想要得到很好的丈夫和孩子。
And we will live together forever.
然后我们就可以永远的生活在一起。
No, you won't live forever.
不会这样的，不可能永远生活在一起。
One lady just said to me the other day how she realized that young people also die.
有一天呢，一个女士就告诉我，她说她有一个觉悟，那些年轻人也会死去的。
And she told me, she said she was supposed to have a child, she was supposed to deliver a child, but something in her body ruptured and she almost died.
她说呢，她有那个怀孕了，然后她本来应该把那个孩子生下来，但是因为她身体出了一些状况。
Yeah,
然后他导致他几乎就快死了。
So she understood that you can die at any time.
所以他就明白了，人他是可以在任何时候死掉的。
Sometimes even young children die.
有的时候，即便是一个很小的孩子也会死掉。
So why does it happen like this in the material world?
所以物质世界里为什么会发生这样的事情呢？
Because the material world is not a place for happiness.
因为物质世界本来就不是一个快乐的地方。
It's a place for suffering.
本来就是一个受苦的地方。
The body is only meant for suffering.
物质躯体，这个躯体就是为了受苦的。
Anything goes wrong with the body, it gives you so much trouble, so much pain.
如果身体就是发生了一些什么毛病的话，你就会要承担很多的痛苦，很多的不便。
To get happiness from the body is so much trouble.
为了从这个物质躯体里面得到一些快乐，你要花很多的，经历很多的麻烦。
And what then happiness is very temporary.
那种快乐呢，也是转瞬即逝，非常短暂的。
It's very quickly finished. The happiness comes to an end very quickly.
那种快乐很快就会结束。
But the miseries, they stay for a long time.
但是痛苦呢却会保持很长一段时间。
So we are given a material body.
所以呢，我们被给予了这样一个物质的躯体。
And we think it's for our enjoyment.
我们认为这个躯体是为了让我们来享受的。
Why we're given the material body is meant to bring us into spiritual consciousness.
我们得到这个物质的躯体是为了让我们恢复灵性的知觉。
And if we don't come to spiritual consciousness, then we we remain in material consciousness.
如果我们没有恢复灵性知觉的话，我们就会待在物质知觉当中。
And the result is that the Lord puts us into this into an unmanifested condition.
而结果呢，就是主会把我们放置在这种不展示的状态当中。
Just like before the creation.
就像在创造之前的那种状态。
Everything is unmanifest.
所有的一切都没有得到展示，都是不展示的。
At the end of the life of Brahma, there is total annihilation.
而在这个主 Brahma 的一生结束的时候呢，就整个都遭到了毁灭。
And at that time, all the living entities enter into Mahavishnu.
而在那个时候呢，所有的生物体都会进入 Mahavishnu 的体内。
That is our unmanifested condition.
那就是生物体不展示的状态。
And we stay in that position for a long time.
我们会在那个处境当中停留很长的时间。
We have to wait for the time to come for the creation again.
你们要在那里等着，下一次创造的时间的到来。
And it takes a long time.
那需要很长的时间。
And then creation begin again. The living entities come out from Mahavishnu.
然后当创造再次发生的时候呢，这些生物体又从 Mahavishnu 的身体当中出来。
And according to our qualification, we're given a body.
根据我们各自的资格，我们得到不同的躯体。
Somebody gets the body of a tree.
有的人会得到树的躯体。
Somebody gets the body of a worm.
有的人会得到蠕虫的躯体。
Somebody gets the body of the dog.
有的人会得到狗的躯体。
And some fortunate souls get the human body.
而一些幸运的灵魂会得到人类的身体。
So this is the nature of the material creation.
所以这就是物质创造的奥秘。
It goes on again and again.
这物质创造它是循环往复，周而复始进行的。
And we have had many, many births in many different bodies.
我们已经在不同的躯体当中有了很多生死的出生。
Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna had forgotten this.
就像在《国家梵歌》当中，阿朱那忘记了他之前的出生。
Krishna told them.We have had many births. He said, I remember, you don't.
Krishna 对阿朱那说道，我们两人都有，我们都有很多次的出生，但我记得你却不行。
And the body we have now is the result of our past work.
而我们现在所拥有的躯体是因为我们过去的活动的结果。
And the things we're doing now will determine the body we take in the future.
而我们现在所从事的活动将决定我们将来得到的躯体。
So we want to understand how to make the how to use this body so that we don't have to take another material body.
所以我们要懂得如何利用我们现在的躯体，让我们以后不需要再接受另一个物质躯体。
It's not wrong to want happiness.
想要得到快乐并不是一件错误的事情。
But we have to know where to find the happiness.
我们要知道我们从哪里才能找到快乐。
Some people are thinking, oh, if I go to Los Angeles, there is happiness there.
有的人 也许会想，哦，我要去洛杉矶，我会在那里得到快乐。
And the person in Los Angeles, she's thinking, if I go to...India, there is happiness.
而在洛杉矶的人会想呢，如果我去了印度，我会在那里找到快乐。
And the person in India is thinking, I want to go to heaven.
而在印度的人在想呢，我要去天堂。
And the people in heaven, they're thinking, I want to stay here forever.
而在天堂的人会想呢，我要永远留在天堂。
But they cannot.
但是他们是不可能做到的。
Even in heaven, they go there for some time and they come back.
在天台的人呢，他们会去那里一段时间，但是一段时间之后，他们又回来了。
Another birth.
再一次的投生。
So this is going on since time immemorial.
所以这一切的，都是从不可追溯的时代开始，就一直在进行着，一直发生着。
The scriptures say, Krishna Balir Mukha, Itaiva Maya Tara Deha Samsara Dukha. The living entity, Anadir Bahir Mukha, Itaiva Maya Tara Deha Samsara Dukha.There's a verse like this. It says that because we have forgotten Krishna since a very, very long time.
经典中呢有一个这样的诗节，其中说到呢，因为我们从不可追溯的时候起就遗忘了 Krishna.
And because of forgetting Krishna, we're looking at the external energy.
因为我们遗忘了 Krishna, 所以我们就寻找这个物质能量。
The Bahir Mukha, there's the external energy, the material world, but there's also the internal energy, the spiritual energy.
有这个外在的能量，物质世界里，的外在能量，但是也有这个内在的能量，灵性世界的内在能量。
We are attracted by all the bright lights of the material world.
我们被这个物质世界的一些这个
所 The bright lights, the lights, you know, they put many signs and
bright lights,
光啊，物质能量的光所吸引啊。
You know, if you go to New York, in New York, there's a place called Times Square.
如果你去纽约的话，在纽约有一个时代广场。
So in that place, there's just so many signs, billboards, you know, billboards.
Neon signs.
就是在那个时代广场那里有很多的这种广告牌呀，挂在那。
Everywhere you look, you see this. Come here, enjoy here.
这个广告牌上面就写着，你们来到这里来享受吧。
无论你看到什么地方，都是一个很大的牌子，告诉你，你应该来这里跟我们一起享受。Right? They're telling you, come and enjoy here.
他们就是要把你招来，然后告诉你在这里享受。
So material people get attracted by all these things.
所以人们被这些事情所吸引了。
Just like sometimes we go on the boat, they have a boat here in Melaka. You can take the boat down the river.
就有的时候呢，我们会去坐船，就比方说在马来西亚这里，你可以坐船去，这个游船。
And you, when you look on the left or on the right, both sides of the river, all you see is.You know, this bar, this restaurant, this club.
如果你坐在这个船上，你从左边看还是右边看，反正这个河的两边都有很多的酒吧呀、俱乐部啊、餐馆呀。
Yeah, this is, you know, they want to attract people.
他们想要吸引人们。
And we get attracted.
而我们被他们吸引了。
We think I will enjoy here.
我们会想啊，我会在那里享受。
But the real enjoyment is within.
但真正的享受是内在的享受。
You have to look within. You have to look at the spiritual energy.
你要向内看，你要看到这个灵性的能量。
Don't be tricked by the material energy.
不要被这个物质能量给耍弄了。
Just like the little mouse, you know, sometimes you have mice, you want to catch the mice. So you put some bait there in the cage, And the mouse comes and he wants, oh, there's some cheese, I will go, I'll eat it. He goes in the cage and then the cage closes, he gets stuck in the cage.
如果你们家里有那个老鼠的话，你们想抓住那个老鼠，你们就会在那里放一个盒子，然后在那个盒子里面呢装一些奶酪，然后这个老鼠闻到奶酪的香味呢，它就会受到诱惑进入到这个盒子里面，但一旦它进入这个盒子里面呢，这个它的那个门就会被关掉，然后它就被关在里面了。
Or the fish, when you go the people go fishing, they put the bait on the hookAnd the fish thinks, oh, something, oh, you're how chitta. And it goes to eat it. Ah!
还有比方说你钓鱼的时候，你就会在那个鱼钩上面放一些那个诱饵，然后扔到河里面，然后那个鱼闻到那个诱饵，它就会跑过来，吃有好吃的啊。然后鱼就这样上钩了。
So we have to be careful not to get hooked by the material world.
所以我们要非常的小心，不要被这个物质世界的这些诱惑所吸引了。
Don't fall in the well.
不要掉入到这个黑井当中。
Right? Once you're in the well, hard to get out.
一旦你掉到这个黑井当中，你是很难出来的。
Or you get hooked, very hard to get free.
嗯，你要想出来，你要变得自由，你要付出很多的努力。
Just like the drug addicts, you know, if they take drugs.
就比方说那些喝毒药成瘾的人。
They become hooked. They can't live without the drug.
他就是变得成瘾，他一旦上瘾的话，如果离开那个毒品，他就没法活。
So materialistic people are all hooked. They're all caught.By the net of Maya.
所以那些物质主义者呢，都被 Maya 的这个罗网给束缚了，就是被捆缚在其中了。
Very hard to get them free.
他们很难得到自由。
So when you fall into this situation, very hard to get out.
当你堕入到这种境况当中的时候，你很难得出来。
So we have to be very careful to hold on to Krishna.
所以我们要非常的，我们要非常的小心，我们要一直抓着 Krishna.
We have to see Krishna everywhere.
我们要看到 Krishna 无处不在。
Yomam pasyati sarvatra sarvam chamai pasyati tasyaham na pranashyami satyami na pranashyati.For one who sees me everywhere,
一个看到我无处不在的人
，and sees everything in me,
他会在他看到万事万物都在我之中。
I am never lost to him.
他从来不会失去我。
And he is never lost to me.
我也从来不会失去他。
So we want to come to that stage of Krishna consciousness.
所以我们要达到这个 Krishna 知觉的境界。
And we have to practice.
这需要一些练习。
Practice chanting, coming, seeing the deities.
我们练习唱诵，练习来见神像。
And gradually, we will become Krishna conscious.
逐渐的呢，我们就会变得有 Krishna 知觉。
Okay, any question?
大家有什么问题吗？
When we fall, if we are from the spiritual world, we fall down, we shouldn't be falling down because when we're in the spiritual world, we won't fall down. But from this verse, it says that the conditioned souls are eternally conditioned. That means when they are expanded from Krishna, they're already conditioned. They're never from the spiritual world. So now, whatever they're doing, they're just trying to go back to the spiritual world. So is it true that actually not all conditioned souls are actually...drop down from the spiritual world in the beginning, or are they just condition straight away once it expanded from Krishna.
You have to do it.
所以说我们的问题就是我们的灵魂就是很多人讲在我们这灵性世界跌下来就是我们就做到条件的灵魂不过我们回去灵性世界应该不会跌下来的嘛是不是因为我们已经跟Krishna一起为什么会跌下来嘛所以这个在今天的讲课常常讲我们的条件的灵魂已经很久就太 不可追溯的时候，不可追溯的时候。啊，不可追，对不起，可以讲了吗？所以我们也已经来了。我们Krishna发生我们的时候，我们已经条件了，所以我们不是在灵性世界来的。所以我们Guru就是，是不是有我们的灵魂？是不是有我们有可能开觉的时候不是在灵性世界？我们已经条件了，所以我们现在是学怎样回去灵性世界。
是不是有是这样的？你们明白吗？他们的意思就是说，因为我们这些受条件限制的灵魂，自不可追溯的时代起就受到条件的限制。 那是不是我们这些在物质世界这些受条件限制的灵魂，是不是从一刚开始就不是那个在灵性世界，而是就是从刚开始就一直在这里？而我们现在做这些练习，就只是做一些练习，然后想要回归灵性世界，是这样吗？
Does it make any difference?
这有什么区别呢？
The important thing is you're here in the material world now.
现在关键的问题就是你现在在这个物质世界里。
You want to get out.
你想要出去。
Don't be so worried about where you came from.
所以不要太担心你是从哪里来的。
Just understand the easiest thing.
只是去理解，只是去明白那些简单的事情。
The easiest thing is how to get out.
简单的事情是你如何出去。
Chant.
你要唱诵,
you have to take up service to Krishna.
你要为Krishna从事服务。
If you do service for Krishna, you become Krishna conscious, and certainly you'll go back and be with Krishna.
如果你为Krishna从事服务的话, 你肯定会获得Krishna知觉, 从而有资格变得回归守成，回到灵性世界。
So it doesn't matter where we came from.
所以我们是从哪里来, 这一点不要紧。
有其他的问题？顶拜Guru Maharaj， 顶拜各位奉献者。那我的问题是，就是我们在这个物质世界，其实也就是走上 Krishna 知觉之路之后呢，修习了很久很久的人，为什么也会堕落？就是。 也有一定的基础了，为什么就是在修着修着它就掉下去了？就是我想问，这究竟什么原因？造成它这种堕落还是Krishna？Why
does somebody become fallen after they've been taking, after they've been doing spiritual practice?
For a long time, so she wants to know what is the reason of their falling.
Well, if they were doing proper spiritual practice, they would not fall.
如果他们做的是恰当的灵性修习的话，他们是不会堕落的。
There's something wrong.
肯定是有哪里出了问题。
If they're going to give up their spiritual practice, it means they were not properly practicing.
如果他们放弃了Krishna知觉，那证明他们没有很恰当的进行修习。
You have to understand, somebody is doing regular spiritual practice, they will not fall.
你要知道，如果一个人是进行有规律的灵性修习的话，他是不会堕落的。
They must have been doing something wrong.
他们肯定是做了某一些不太恰当的事情，不太正确的事情。
You may have seen or they come for the program every week.
你也许会看到说他那个人每周都来参加节目。
But that's not enough.
但那是不足够的。
You just come once a week.
他只是一周来一次而已。
For a few hours.
只是每次也只是来几个小时。
What do they do the rest of the week?
那这一周剩下的时间他在做什么呢？
Must be doing something.
他一定在做什么事情。
And they're definitely not doing regular spiritual practice.
那肯定他没有有规律的去从事灵性的修行。
Because if they were doing regular spiritual practice, they will not fall down.
因为如果他有规律的去从事灵性修行的话，他是不会堕落的。
It doesn't happen. If somebody is very regularly hearing and chanting, they'll be protected from the material energy.
如果一个人有规律的从事聆听和唱诵的话，他们是会受到保护的，保护他们免于物质能量的影响。
Yes.Any other questions?
还有其他的问题吗？
是的，姑娘，我想请问，这个所谓物质世界、灵性世界，是不是我们的意识状态而就是认为的？比如说，我们去到文达本，印度的文达本，我们就感觉到了灵性世界。我们来到这里就感觉到了灵性世界。如果我们处在另外一种物质的状态当中，我们就感觉是在物质世界。所以说，是不是我们的意识状态，决定我们是在灵性世界还是在物质世界？
意识状态，
或者是知觉状态？
知觉状态。OK。So he's asking about the condition. When we go to Vrindavan, we think, oh, we're in the spiritual world. And when we're here, some places, when we're here, we think also this is a spiritual world. But some places we think, oh, this is a material world. So he's saying, is this our own consciousness?
His question is that our consciousness decides.That we are in the material world or spiritual world, is that right?
Well, the pure devotees, Prabhupada would say, although I'm sitting in New York, he said, I'm always thinking of Vrindavan.
虽然帕乌帕说到，这样纯粹奉献者，虽然帕乌帕说到，即便是我在纽约，但是我总是想着文达文。
So wherever the pure devotee goes, they can think that the spiritual world.
所以呢，对于一个纯粹奉献者而言，无论他走到哪里，他都会认为那里是灵性世界。
At the same time, they're also conscious of where they are.
但同时呢，他们也知觉到他们身处的地方。
Prabhupada was in England, in the UK, in London.And he was interviewed. The reporter asked him, "What is it like in hell?"
有一次呢，说到帕瓦帕在英国的伦敦，然后有一个记者就问他，那个地狱是什么样的
？And Prabhupada said, "This is hell. This is London."
然后帕瓦帕就回答说，这就是地狱，这伦敦就是。
Every day cloudy, never see the sun.
每一天都是雾霾重重的，从来见不到阳光。
Every day dark and wet.
每一天都很黑，很潮，很潮湿，很寒冷。
So, you know, Prabhupada also could understand. He was explaining, "Oh, this is a material world."
所以，说到方法在解释，这就是物质世界的样子。
Pure devotee can also see the material world. He can see the spiritual world.
所以纯粹奉献者既可以看到物质世界，也可以看到灵性世界。
And so Krishna is everywhere. Krishna is also in the material world.
Krishna 他是无处不在的。Krishna 也在物质世界里。
But of course, this material world, this is not a very pleasing place to Krishna.
当然了，这个物质世界并不太取悦 Krishna。
Some places are more pleasing to him than others.
有一些地方对他来说，让他得到更大的快乐，比起其他的地方。
But wherever the devotee goes, he will see that everywhere he can do devotional service.
但是一个奉献者，无论他走到哪里，他都可以从事奉献服务。
He doesn't think, "Oh, this is a material world. I can't serve Krishna here."
他不会去想，哦，这里是物质世界，我不能在这里服务 Krishna。
I have to go to the spiritual world, then I can serve Krishna.
我只有去了灵性世界，我才能服务 Krishna。
No, we have to serve Krishna everywhere.
不是这样的，我们在任何地方都可以服务 Krishna。
Narayana parasave naktaschanya vidyate swarga apavarga narakesh vipitu yata darshana. The devotees of the Lord, they will not see any difference between heaven and hell and liberation.
主的奉献者不会区分天堂、地狱和解脱。
Everywhere they will see the opportunity for devotional service.
他们在每一个地方都能够看到从事奉献服务的机会。
So, although it may be the material world, still devotional service can be done.
所以，即便是他们还在物质世界，但是仍然可以在这里从事奉献服务。
There's a lot of preaching to be done in the material world.
在物质世界里有很多传播的工作要去做。
In the spiritual world, everyone's a pure devotee.
在灵性世界里，每个人都是纯粹奉献者。
So there's not much preaching needed there.
所以那里没有什么传教的活动。
But still, of course, you can have sadhu sangha.
当然了，你可以有sadhu sangha，有圣人的联谊。
Association discuss Krishna's pastimes.
可以在这个联谊当中一起讨论有关 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
So devotee's business is the same wherever he goes.
所以奉献者的活动都是一样的，无论他去哪里。
Material world or spiritual world.
无论是在物质世界还是在灵性世界。
You can't think, oh, now I'm in the spiritual world, now I don't need to chant anymore.
你不能说我现在在物质世界里，那我不念诵好了。
Now I'm here, I'm back to Godhead, now I'm back to Godhead, I don't need to do any more seva.
你不会说这个，我去了灵性世界，我就不需要再做任何服务了。
No. We're supposed to practice here.And we will continue when we go there.
不是这样的。我们现在在这里进行练习，但是呢，当我们回到灵性世界的时候，我们会继续这些活动。
Just like in the spiritual world, the devotees are making garlands for Krishna.
就比方说，在灵性世界里，奉献者们也会为 Krishna 穿那个美丽的花环。
And they're cooking the milk, they're boiling the milk, and making the yogurt, and making the sweets for Krishna.
他们也会这个挤那个牛奶，然后用那个牛奶做黄牛做甜品，然后给 Krishna.
The one devotee, he was always meditating on his, because he understood his position in the spiritual world. So he was always meditating on cooking the milk for Krishna.
有一个奉献者呢，因为他已经认识到了自己的灵性身份，所以他总是在那里冥想，他在灵性世界里为 Krishna 煮这个牛奶。
And in his meditation, he was always,You know, when you cook the milk, you have to be careful. Milk won't boil over because it rises up. It gets hot, it boils up and can boil over. So you have to stir it so it doesn't boil over.
所以你们知道，在煮牛奶的时候呢，因为那个牛奶它一旦受热的时候，它就会升腾起来。 然后可能就会溢出来，所以你们在煮牛奶的时候就要一直小心那个牛奶不要溢出来。
And so the devotee was always, he was in his meditation, he was always cooking the milk.
所以这个复健者在他的冥想当中，他总是在煮着牛奶。
And his hands got all burned.
然后他的手呢都被烫伤了。
Because sometimes you have to pick up the pot, take it off the stove.
有的时候因为你要把那个牛奶罐呀从那个火炉灶上面拿下来。
So his hands were all burned.
所以他的手呢就都被烫伤了。
Because he was doing this in his meditation.
因为他在他的冥想当中，这么做了这个活动。
So if we see some of you with your hands all burnt, then we will understand that you've been cooking the milk for Krishna.
所以如果我们看到你们当中有些人如果手被烫伤了，就知道你们肯定是为 Krishna 煮过牛奶。
今天就讲到这里，哈利·克里斯纳。
Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai.